Hi all, myself Udit Pratap Bhatnagar. I along with Radish Gupta and Gulshan Noyesh, we're going to present this presentation. The topic selected is here is nanorobot, the medicine of the future. It's really an advanced topic. Right now it is not yet commercialized and it's in the novel stage. Large number of researches are going to be done throughout the world on this topic and a good success ratio. So it's the future. These are the content of the presentation. Starting with the nanotechnology, we're gonna explain briefly about the nanorobots and the molecular nanotechnology and their working with the applications and finally the conclusion. So, what is nanotechnology? We all know that the nanotechnology is the art of manipulating the matters at the nanoscales. Just to give you a feel of the nanotechnology, I'm talking about the dimensions. It is the 1 millionth of your hair diameter. Imagine a machine of this size. What it gonna do? Unbelievable things. As we can see in the figure, a nanorobot in your bloodstream is there. What it can do? It can act as a doctor inside your bloodstream. Imagine a doctor inside you. So, the nanorobot. The machine I am talking about is a nanorobot. Nanorobot, it's a tiny machine designed to perform a specific task repeatedly in the nanoscale dimensions. These can be used to fight against the bacteria and the viruses. Imagine that a nanorobot can lead to fight the uncurable diseases like AIDS. So the deadly disease can also be treated by the nanorobots. It can fight inside you with the target locations and it can be very good. And the future of medicine is bright. Now, the next slide. In this slide, I am talking about the molecular nanotechnology. It refers to the nanoscale engineering system that developed by the combination of the molecules. As we can see in the figure, a molecular structure is designed to do a specific task on the surface shown. So imagine that this is your cell surface. Your cell is going to be heated by the bacteria. So we can do anything that we want. This is a revolutionary technique in this field and has some medical application and also in the defense applications. So, what are the things you must know about the MNT, molecular nanotechnology? So, the first of all is the what are different type of technologies gonna be used. The first is chromalocytes. The second is respirocytes. So what are the risks involved in the nanosciences? We all gonna present this and the potential benefits of the MNT and the potential dangers of the molecular nanotechnology. So what is chromalocytes? Chromalocytes are basically a long shaped mobile robot. It consists of about a trillion atom. It's just like a chromosome of the body. It can be replaced by the chromosome. So imagine your chromosome is replaced by a with the chromalocytes. Then if you can see in the figure, this is the specific diagram that's showing how the similarity in the chromosome and the chromalocytes. So chromosomes are the building blocks of the DNA. Many incurable genetic diseases, including the mental retardedness of the person, can be cured by this, and very deadly diseases can also be cured by this. The next part of this is going to be presented by Mr. Radish Gupta. And thank you all.
Thanks, Udit. Greetings to Namada, sir. I'm going to present the next part of the slide. Now, what is a respirocyte? Respirocyte is a kind of artificial robot that floats in the bloodstream. It functions similarly as the red blood cells, carries oxygen with them, unload oxygen at specified location, and then carry CO2 while returning back. But respirocyte have the ability to deliver oxygen 236 times as per unit volume than natural red blood cell. We can see in this figure the respirocytes in the bloodstream and also the red blood cells. Now, everything has its pros and cons. There are also some risks involved in the technological advancement in the nanotechnology, like use of nanoscience in weapons. We also going to discuss the detailed risk involved in this in the upcoming slides. Now, what is the potential benefit of micro nanotechnology? Micro nanotechnology, as we know that it involves the principles of biophysics, chemistry and other nanotechnologies to build the microscopic devices on the nanoscale. So we can see this as we can manipulate each individual molecule as our own demand. So by manipulating individual molecule, it can be used to build light and strong structures and electrical equipment in very cheap and efficient cost. So it also used to eradicate many diseases and restore the environment, as it is very environmental friendly. Now, the benefits of micro nanotechnology. Micro nanotechnology is self-contained and is very clean. It is also very cheap and can be used in advanced equipment for medical research and healthcare. Computers and display devices become very stunningly cheap by using micro nanotechnologies. There are also lot of uses of micro nanotechnologies. Along with the potential dangers of micro nanotechnologies, this we can see in this slide. It has the potential to disrupt the society in many aspects. It may cause two competing nations to disruptive arm race. Overuse of inexpensive products could cause widespread environmental damage. To control these environmental impacts, government may impose abusive restrictions which may be dangerous at some point of time. In this slide, we look upon how to power the nanorobots, how nanorobots get their power. So nanorobots could get power directly from the blood streams. Another option is to supply energy externally by acoustic signals. So now in this slide we look upon how nanorobot will work. Doctors can keep track on the nanorobots with the ultrasonic signals. In this figure we can see that a robot is swimming through the arteries and veins with a pair of appendages at the end. Nanorobots will be detected by MRI signal device, radioactive dye, X-ray, radio waves to confirm that it will reach its destined path. Next of the slides will be covered by Gulchan. Thank you.
Greeting to Nimani sir. Hi to all my friends. Now I continue my topic on the nano robots. As far as we have understand the working of the nano robots, let us now understand how to put nano robot at the desired site. Basically, we require a pushing force. First possibility can be flow of the blood, but it has some practical limitation. We require uninterrupted blood flow at the site of the action. Another, there can be limitation as the blood clot or tumor, so it becomes a barrier. Scientists intensively understand the behavior of microorganism in the body, and they found that microorganism uses some vibration in order to move in their specific direction, although they can move in any direction. That special structure in the microorganism is called cilia. That cilia helps them in order to move in any direction. They have studied this type of behavior in Paramecium, E. coli, where they use flagella and cilia. They have the similar kind of structure. As we have gone through with this structure of the nanorobot, which has some capacitors, that capacitor can also produce the magnetic field. That magnetic field can produce the conducive fluid around it, just like the airplane. And miniaturizing of this jet pump could even use blood plasma to push the nanorobot forward through the electromagnetic pump. This is how the movement is possible with the help of electromagnetic field. As you can see in this diagram that the study of E. coli bacterium, you have a different flagellum which has a long structure and that helps in the movement in any direction. You can observe this, the force can be observed in any direction, in random direction, and as a shape of it, that in the tail part they have the flagellum, in the front part they have no tail part. So they observe a pushing force in the forward direction. So let's move another. How the actions of nanorobots are being observed? These actions nothing but the application of nanorobots. You can see by understanding is the they help in breaking up the blood clots, fighting with the cancer, parasite removal, grout, and cleaning wounds. Field of application, you can see that the field of application has been a wide application of it. Nanotechnology, nanorobots are helpful in denticizing tooth oral anesthesia, straightening of irregular set of teeth, and improvement of teeth durability, and also improve the appearance of the teeth. Treating of arteriosclerosis, it referred to a condition where the plaque built along the wall of arteries. Nanorobots could conceitedly treat this condition by cutting away the plaque, which would then enter the blood stream. The device working in this fashion has been shown over here. You can observe that the blood corpuscles has been shown over here, and the inside portion of the blood corpuscle has been attached with the plug, hence narrowing the path for the blood to flow. So we can see that the flow has been very narrow, that will lead to the heart attack within the body. So we have to remove it, and nanorobot can be helpful for such kind of activity. So device that is being injected within the bloodstream that could nibble at the arteriosclerosis deposit, widening the affected blood vessel, that you can see in the given diagram. Nanotechnologies is also useful in the treatment of the cancer, that helpful in removing the special structure of the nanorobot has been designed, which captures the microorganism that is parasite to the body, and they just capture just like amoeba does. Researchers are hoping that they can treat the cancer as well with the help of nanorobot. Actually, the leukemia cell, which has been found within a cancer patient, the design, a specific design of a robot that attack on the DNA and destroy the cancer cell. With the help of laser, microwave, and ultrasound signal, they could be a part of chemotherapy treatment as well, delivering medication directly to the cancer site. Precise amount of medication reduce the side effect, so it becomes a very revolutionary technique in order to treat the different patient suffering from the deadly diseases. Now, nanorobot can carry different technology with it to treat a specific disease, like it carries fiber optics technology, laser technology, telemedicine, sound waves, nuclear radiation, and each of these technology has a specific importance. That is, you can see that it utilizes in fiber optics utilizes in endoscopic medicine. Fiber optic instrument are introduced into the body cavity through a tiny hole made on the body to investigate to treat the ailment. As we talk about the laser technology utilized in cataract surgery and removal of gallbladder and bladder stone. On conclusion, we can say that current development in the nanotechnology directs human step closer to the nanorobots and operating nanorobots in future of nanotechnology. Nanorobots can theoretically destroy all common diseases of 21st century, thereby ending much of the pain and suffering. It can also an alternative to the mouthwash and cosmic cream that can expand the commercial market in biological engineering. People can envision a future where people can itself diagnose their own ailments with the help of nanorobots monitor in their bloodstream. Thank you.